that can stand alone. One depends on the other. In math, it is known to be functional notation. On this lesson, we're going to differentiate between the independent and dependent variable in real-life situation. We're going to identify which is the independent and dependent variable in the given A, we have time X versus salary, study habit versus grades, price, and commodity, distance, and the volume of the gas. So the first example, the first given in our identifying the dependent and the independent variable is, first you have the time and the salary. So the salary, it will be the our dependent variable because it depends in our independent variable.
Well, the next one is the grades and our study habit.
So the grades will be the dependent variable, which is depend in our independent variable, that is study habit. And the third one, we have the price. It depends upon the type or brand and the quality of the commodity. And the last one, we have the distance covered. It is the dependent because it depends on the volume of
another thing to identify if it's independent and dependent variable. It explains this one.
So the dependent and independent variables. In an equation where y is expressed in terms of x, the variable x is considered the independent variable because any value could be assigned to it. However, the variable y is the dependent variable because its values depend on the value of x. So we have f of x is equal to ax. Again, we're going to read it. F of x, where f is the name of the functions. X is an input value from the domain of the functions. It is the independent. And the f of x is the function value or the y value corresponding to x. So, yung y natin sa linear equation, ginawa po natin siya equal sa f of x. Because the value of x, we're going to substitute in the given linear equation or in function to find the value of our f of x or the y functions. Again, to express the relation of the previous situation, we're going to use y is equal to f of x. Again, we're going to read it is f of x. If f of x denotes a certain function of x, then f of a denotes the value of f of x, where x is equal to a. The value of the function is found by substituting the value of a for x in the expression of f of x. And of course, the process of performing the indication operation after substituting the assigned value of each independent variable in the functional relation, it is called evaluation. So it is important that we're going to use the GEMDAS or the PEMDAS. We have the GEMDAS, it is grouping, symbol, exponent, multiplication, division, addition, and subtraction. That is the rule will be performed in evaluating a function. How about the PEMDAS? So PEMDAS, it is the parentheses, exponent,
equal to 2x squared minus 4x plus 1. We're going to find the f of negative 2, f of 0, and f of 12. Again, we're going to substitute the value of x in the given function notation. Now, let us solve the given. So, we have the f of x is equal to 2x squared minus 4x plus 1. Then, we're going to find the f of negative 2. So, we're going to substitute the value of x, which is equal to negative 2 in the given equation. So, we have x of negative 2 is equal to, copy, 2. Then, what is the value of x? We have negative 2 squared minus 4 times the value of negative 2 plus 1. So, we're going to use the GEMDAS or PEMDAS. So, we have first the exponent. So, we have f of negative 2 is equal to negative 2 squared is 2 times, we have positive 4, minus 4 times negative 2 plus 1. Next, multiplication. So we have 2 times 4, it's 8, minus 4 times negative 2, it is negative 8 plus 1. Then, it is f of negative 2, 8. Negative times negative, it becomes positive 8 plus 1. Then, we're going to add. F of negative 2 is equal to 8 plus 1 is equal to 17. So, we have the function f of x is equal to 2x squared minus 4x is equal to 1. If our f of negative 2, we have f of negative 2 is equal to 17. How about the next letter one. B? We have f of 0. So, we're going to substitute the value of x in the given equation again. So, right, f of 0 is equal to, copy the equation, 2x squared minus 4x plus 1. Then, substitute the value of x, which is 0. So, 2 times 0 squared minus 4 times 0 plus 1. Then, exponent, GEMDAS. So, we have 0 squared is 0. So, 2 times 0 is minus 4 times 0 plus 1. Then, multiply. F of 0 is equal to 2 times 0 is 0 minus 4 times 0 is 0 plus 1. So, 0 plus 1 is 1. So, we have the f of 0 is equal to 1. Equation. Next, we have letter C. So, C is f of 12. So, copy. F of 12 is equal to, copy the given equation, 2x squared minus 4x plus 1. Then, substitute the value of x, which is equal to 12. So, 2 times 12 squared minus 4 times 12 plus 1. Again, we're going to substitute the value of x in all x in the given equation. Okay? Next. So, we have 2. What is 12 squared? It is 144 minus 4 times 12 plus 1. Then, f of 12. So, we have 2 times 144. It is 288 minus, what is 4 times 12? It is 48 plus 1. So, f of 12 is equal to, what is 288 minus 48. So we have 240. Plus 1. Or you can use also the 48 plus 1, it is 49. It's the same thing because gem does, if it's addition and subtraction, with simple, the first operation, it will be the first. So we have f of 12 is equal to 241. So another example, give the domain of f of x is equal to 1 half x plus 3. As d, or the domain, is equal to 2, 4, and 8. What is the range of the function? Again, the domain is all the value of x, or the first element. Then, the range is the y, which is y is equal to f of x. So, let us solve. Let us solve. So, we have the equation, or the function, f of x is equal to 1 half x plus 3. So first domain, or the value of x we have, is f of x is equal to 2. So we have 1 half x plus 3, then 1 half times the value of x is 2 plus 3. So we have 1 times 2, it is 2. Divide by 2, it is 1, or you can just cancel. We have 1 plus 3. Then what is 1 plus 3? The f of 2 is equal to 4. How about f is equal to 4? So we have same given function plus 3. So we have 1 half, then x is 4 plus 3. 4 times 1, it is 4 divided by 2, it is 2. Or just cancel, it becomes 2. 2 times 1 is 2 plus 3. Then we have 2 plus 3 is 5. So we have f of 4 is equal to 5. Next, how about if our f is equal to 8? So given, we have 1 half x plus 3. Then substitute 1 half. What is x? 8 plus 3. If we have 8 times 1, 8 times 1, we have 8 divided by 2. It is 4 plus 3. Then we have 7. So we have f of 8 is equal to 7 in the given function. Another example is expressing each statement using function notation. So here we're going to have a statement, then we're going to translate it in function notation. For example, we have letter A, y is 500 when x is equal to 25. So we all know that y is equal to f of x, right? Then we have the value of x, which is 25. So this is the same as saying f of 25 is equal to 500. Letter B, find the value of y that corresponds to the value of x, which is x is equal to 3. This is the same as saying f of 3. Then we have another, how much do 3 kilograms of chickens cost if it sell for 150 pesos per kilogram? This is the same as saying f of 3 is equal to 150. So that's all for now. So our lesson is all about function notation, which is our x is the independent, then y is the dependent variable. Then we have all know that y is equal to